Welcome to the Keepsake of Supplies channel. I'm Nikki Kaminka and today I'm going to show you how to make a cremation ashes charm bead with a forever in my heart core. You'll need the following supplies: a heavy duty safety mask, vinyl gloves, one of our forever in my heart core sets, our medium charm bead mould, cremation ashes spoon, small pestle and mortar, UV resin, cocktail stick, and resin sparkle mix. You'll also need mini side cutting pliers, a carbide burr bit, a rotary tool with flex shaft, 4mm doming punch, and a wooden doming block. I like to use a 48 watt LED UV lamp to save energy and make sure the pieces don't get too hot. This one has a 99 second low heat setting. Preparing your supplies. Check you have everything you need before you start. Double check your client's name and order number against what they've ordered. You can take a tiny spoonful of ashes and grind them a little finer if you need to, then clean the spoon. I'd recommend making two charm beads at the same time to give your client the choice. Filling with resin. Very slowly fill your charm bead mould with resin. The pouring spout allows space for bubbles to rise. If you end up with lots of bubbles at this stage, it's easiest to cure it now, then remove and discard the resin and start again. Adding cremation ashes. Add a tiny spoonful of your resin sparkle mix, then your cremation ashes. Don't use too much colour or it won't cure. Use a cocktail stick to carefully poke them into the centre. Focus on the area around the core. If you have too much excess resin in the spout, it will be more work to remove later, so take some out if needed. If you want lots of depth to your bead, then don't bring the colour to the edges. Curing and cooling. Cure for 99 seconds before the ashes have a chance to sink. Cool completely, then flip over and cure again for another 99 seconds. Give it time to cool again before you touch it. A good way to help it cool quickly is by placing the mould on a cool tile. When the top feels cold, carefully remove the bead without touching the shiny part. Allow it to cool completely. Proof photo. Send your client a photo of the charm beads to make sure they're happy with the colour and choose their favourite charm bead. This removes any complaints of, "I don't like the colour," after you set the core and post it. Preparing the bead. Make sure you wear a mask doing this part. Use a pair of mini side cutting pliers to remove the excess from the pouring spout. Sometimes this is enough, but usually you'll then need to use a carbide burr bit to flatten the top. This area will be covered by your charm core. Double check the bead for imperfections. You can wipe it with rubbing alcohol to remove any dust and stickiness. Setting the core. I like to use a wooden doming block as a secure base, but you can place it on a folded rag instead. Put the stamped part A, what I call the mushroom, through the front of the bead. Slot part B over it at the back. If part B won't fit, use the drill bit to remove a little bit more resin. Put the 4mm doming punch in the centre of the core at the back and press gently until it flares. I don't recommend using a bead corer or press here because they can warp the core out of shape. If you don't have the strength, you can use a hammer, but you must be very gentle. Now you have a finished cremation ashes charm bead for your client. Let me know in the comments if you'd like to see more videos like this. And don't forget, I've linked to the blog and all the supplies you'll need down below. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the notifications bell so that you know when I upload more videos. I've put the link to some videos you might like: a cremation ashes heart necklace and a lock of hair charm bead with glue-in inserts. The next two videos I have planned are a lock of hair ring and a breast milk teardrop necklace using the Milky Mama Magic Dust, which is a breast milk preservation powder we're now stocking at Keepsake Supplies. Now, relax and do some crafting.